Hello, and welcome to another edition of Coffee Talk with immigration attorney Brian D. Lerner. We're talking in this set of videos about what can be done to get back to the United States after being deported. And I just did a video on what to do to show extreme hardship, but there's some finer points that I'd like to get into in this particular video about showing extreme hardship to U.S. citizen children, which can bolster the application even more and show more probabilities of success if you can add these items to the general items needed to show extreme hardship. Now, keep in mind that, you know, it will vary depending upon each particular case and so forth, but you should look into this in order to submit the most evidence possible for the waivers in order to get to that point where it would be approved by showing sufficient extreme hardship. So one thing you should get is a professional evaluation of the child's language capabilities. You know, obviously, if the child's going to have to go with you to another country and English is not the first language there, and there's going to be significant problems, there should be a professional evaluation stating this. You should also get individual medical and psychological reports by expert witnesses, which would indicate the potential impact of relocation to a foreign country, and it would show the child's development would be slowed and the ability to flourish would be negated. Really getting a good evaluation of how a move to another country would harm this child. You should get authoritative documentation indicating the similarities and differences between the school systems in the U.S. and the foreign countries. So specifically, if they're going to be basically with you, and if you happen to be in a third world country or one where the school system is far inferior or learns at a much slower pace than the United States, that would definitely need to be included. You should submit recognized sociological studies reflecting the ability of U.S. children to adapt to different cultures and countries. Basically, you want reports showing how difficult it will be for the child to adapt. You should submit any information concerning the child's ability to maintain contacts with their aunts, their uncles, their grandparents, friends, teachers, influential figures in the U.S. And what you want to show is they won't be able to have such contact. It'll be difficult. They'll be able to not see them very often, depending upon where the deportation occurred. So you want to show the difficulty in adapting in the new country with all of these factors. And this would significantly aid in the hopeful approval of the waiver so that you will be able to eventually come back to the United States. Okay, more on the coming videos.